This game is called Keep the Leftovers. In this game, you will practice exchanging money and dividing it into equal groups to find the amount left over. To play, you will need one die, real or play money, and a deck of cards. Remove the tens, jacks, kings, and jokers from the deck. Let the ace equal 1 and the queen equal 0. All other cards represent the number on the card. Let's go over how to play. On your turn, flip two cards to determine an amount of money in cents. The first card represents the tens digit and the second card represents the units digit. Model the amount of money with your coins. Roll a die. This is the number of people who will share the money. If you roll a 1, roll again. Figure out the largest amount of money each person gets so that all players get the same amount of money. Exchange coins for denominations that can be partitioned into the number of groups you need. Let's play! For our 37 cents, we will need 3 piles with the same number of coins in each. If we exchange the quarter for 2 dimes and 5 pennies, it will make the division into 3 piles easier. Make piles of money for each person. Keep the leftover 1 penny. Your turn ends and play moves to the left. After 4 rounds, the player with the most money wins. Let's do another round. We flip 2 eights so we have 88 cents. We rolled a 6, so we need to divide our change into 6 equal groups with the least amount left over. We represent 88 cents with change like this. Now, we'll exchange each quarter for 2 dimes and a nickel. We'll divide those dimes into 6 piles. Now, we'll exchange our 5 nickels for 5 pennies each. Once we divide our pennies into 6 groups, we have 4 pennies left over. Think about these questions as you play. When are the leftovers largest? When you share an amount among 5 people, or when you share the same amount among 3 people? Why do you think so? When you share an amount of money among 4 people, what are the possible amounts of leftovers? There are a couple variations to this game. You can use real coins you don't mind giving away and have the players keep what they win or trade it in for privileges. Another variation is to practice with dollar amounts. In this variation, let the number you get from the cards represent an amount in dollars rather than cents and use play dollar bills as well as coins. To play this version, children separate the dollar amounts, then break down any leftover dollars into smaller denominations, so that the leftover amounts are pennies.